Hello, ServiceNow friends, builders, developers, admins, everybody. Welcome back to Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. Today, we're going to do a deep dive into GlideAjax. So GlideAjax is the bridge for client-server communication. It allows your client scripts to talk to your server-side scripts and get information from the server when you don't have that connection going on at the moment. That sounds like a lot. And you might not have known what anything I just talked about, and that's okay. I'm going to try to explain it to you and illustrate some of that for you in this lesson. So it's not one of the easiest concepts to get inside ServiceNow if you're brand new to things, but it's very important because it comes out a lot when you start building your apps. And let me kind of show you what I'm talking about. So if I'm navigating a website, not just ServiceNow, any website, when you're clicking around and you click on a link, so when I click on this incident link, I'm asking the server that has all this information to give me information to and display it on my screen. That is interacting with their server. But now that the web page is loaded, I'm no longer interacting with that server. I can edit all of these different fields, and nothing is actually happening on the server until I press update or any other action that would say, hey, it's time to update the server. So even though I have changed some of these values, it doesn't look like that in the server. It's still in my browser. And then it doesn't do anything until I call the server again with clicking on another button like update. So what we're gonna learn with GlideAjax today is say that we want something to happen based off of information that we have from the server, but after the page has already loaded. So even though by normal behavior, if I change impact to low and nothing happens on the server, what if I do want something to happen from the server, whether something updates on the server or I just get information that I don't have on the screen now to display to the user? So it's a way to communicate to the server after we've already hung up the phone. We're going to go to this place called client scripts, and we're going to create a new client script. So I'm on the client script table now, and I'm going to say new client script. And in this client script, I'm going to name it, we're going to just say test client script, just for the sake of this exercise. And I'm going to run it on the incident table because I want it to happen when I'm on the incident table. And we're going to do it whenever a certain field changes. And just like what we were talking earlier, we're going to say when the priority changes, we're going to do something with the script. So, and honestly, for a lot of people using GlideAjax, you're honestly going to go look up a GlideAjax template and copy and paste it. But for this lesson, I'm going to go ahead and type it out for you. We're going to go ahead and create a new GlideAjax, and we're going to say new GlideAjax, and we're going to call it my server code. And we'll come back to this later. But this is going to be the server-side script that we create later. And we're going to say add a parameter. And we're going to call that parameter sysparm name. And that's kind of like standard of how people name their GlideAjax parameters. They started with sysparm. And then this one's specific because sysparm name is looking for a specific method within your server-side script, and we'll get there again. A lot of this is like I'm talking in circles, so you'll see when we get to the end. And we're going to look for the method specifically called get server time. All right, so how GlideAjax works is once you have parameters, you're going to say this thing called get XML, and we're going to name a function that we want it to run once it gets that payload. Once it gets the answer to whatever we're calling right now. We're going to create a function called handle response, the one that we're calling earlier. And we're going to take that response, and we are going to say the server time, what we're looking for, is the response, XML. Stay with me here. It's a lot, I know. And we're going to say the document element, and we're going to say get attribute answer. And with that, we're going to say alert. This is what happens when we actually get that information. Server time. The server time is, and the server time, the variable we just created. That's a lot. Okay, let's talk about it. What is this monstrosity? response.responseXML.documentElement.getAttribute answer. Honestly, don't worry about it so much when you're starting off. Honestly, a lot of us advanced users don't worry about it so much. It's just how GlideAjax was built to be able to handle the different information passing from server to client side outside of your normal clicking around the interface. It's doing this thing in the background, taking the information that you gave it, taking the information that was coming from the server, and it packages it into this thing called an XML response. And XML is read by certain parameters and methods itself. So all you have to do is honestly copy and paste this long string into your script and just debug it and test it and make sure it works. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. We're going to go ahead and submit this so it saves. And then we're going to move over to the server-side script. Inside of my instance, I have script includes, and we're going to go ahead and go to script includes now. And we're going to create a new script include. So this script include, so a script include is kind of like a new library of code that I want to reuse in the future. And for this instance, I'm going to be using this code for my GlideAjax. And remember earlier, we called our script include my server code. So we're going to do the same thing here. The name of this is my server code. And we're going to make sure it's client callable because it's coming from a client. And so inside here, I'm going to go ahead and create a new method called, what did I call it earlier? Get server time. Very straightforward function. We're just going to get the date time according to the server. And we're going to build a new method in here. And we're going to say return new glide date time and get display value. All right, so really simple. You'll notice that I'm returning something because if we're calling this function from a client, we need to return something to it. So I'm returning what I want in that return statement. So that looks pretty straightforward. I'm going to go ahead and save this now. And it's going to ask me a user role for access control on this one, and I'm just going to give it admin for the sake of testing this. Okay, so now we have created the client side of the script, and now we've created the server side of the script. Let's go ahead and test it. Let's go back to incident, because that's where we asked it to run. And I'm going to open up a random incident. Okay, so now in the incident table, the way you change the priority field is by changing the impact or urgency, in case you didn't know that. So if I want to change the priority, I'm going to change the impact, and it changed to moderate. You'll see that it changed. But the moment that the priority changed, it triggered my client script that was waiting for something to change like that. And then in that script, it called the server-side script. And that server-side script got the information that I needed, the server time, went back to the client script, and then displayed it in an alert. Oh, goodness, that was a lot of stuff. All you need to remember is that a GlideAjax is a way for your web browser or the user's web browser to interact with the server when it's not already talking to the server. That's the main thing you need to know. And GlideAjax looks intimidating at first, but a lot of us still copy and paste it from other people's examples all the time still. Even me, I will look up my own old versions of GlideAjax and copy and paste them into new versions because I haven't memorized that long strings of code and stuff like that. So it's okay. But now you're exposed to GlideAjax, and honestly, you'll probably use it. So see you next time.